What is this? And how could this teeny tiny technology from France save farming in parched African countries? Rabi, who owns this massive olive farm in Tunisia, is showing me how a recent French invention known as Polyter has saved his olive trees from severe drought. It's not just in Tunisia. Polyter is used all over Africa and beyond. These villagers, who might otherwise have been displaced, say the technology has helped them beat climate change. This farmer says Polyter has also helped improve the quality of his dates.
Polyter.
What exactly is Polyter, and why is it described as a miracle technology? I am in Tunisia. Located in North Africa, Tunisia is a cradle of civilization, with a history stretching back thousands of years. Behind me is the oldest mosque in Africa. It's actually one of the oldest mosques in the whole Islamic world. It dates back to Prophet Muhammad's era. More than 12 million people live in this coastal country, home to stunning beaches and a breathtaking Mediterranean climate. Tunisia also breeds revolutions, toppling dictators. But in recent years, Tunisia has faced a new and potentially graver threat than it has ever known. I've come to Tunisia because there has been 4 years of severe drought in a row. There has been barely any rainfall. The situation is so dire that the government has started rationing water, including cutting off the supply at night. Experts describe the crisis in cataclysmic terms. This climate crisis, which is also affecting other countries with less or more severity, is expected to create 200 million refugees by 2050, unless technological breakthroughs disrupt it. We're now on our way to see the impact of one such tech on the ground. But now, my local companion and friend Yamin wants us to stop the car. He's showing us a devastating impact of climate change on his country. Unlike other oil-rich Arab countries, Tunisia has no natural resources to speak of. Its economy is largely dependent on agriculture. And nothing is grown here more than olives. Olive farms are everywhere. Even in space, you could see Tunisia's olive farms. Did you know that Tunisia is the world's fifth largest exporter of olive oil, providing more than 150 million kilograms of the liquid gold to the world? Then I had to deal with a disruptive natural force. I'm now in the middle of a major olive farm in southern Tunisia. Tunisia is one of the world's largest exporters of olive. The farm belongs to this man, Rabi. It's in Feriana, a small town in the southern Kasserine province. He says drought has been threatening the farm on which his life depends.
مع التغير المناخي هذا أصبحت الأمطار ضعيفة جدا. الأمطار هذه خلت إنه الإنتاج يتضائر من سنة إلى أخرى.
With a background in agricultural engineering, Rabi decided to look for novel solutions from other countries, and that's how he found Polyter.
معناها برودوي معجزة. معجزة دون لو سونس إنه التكنولوجيا نتاعو قوية برشا.
When I asked him to elaborate, he pointed to a specific tree.
أنا هذه شجرة متاع زيتون عمرها توا عام وخمسة شهر. معناها فلاح آخر ما صدقش لي شجرة هذه عمرها عام وخمسة شهر. إنه هذين في العادة كنا هذه إنتاج متاع توصل النمو هذي عم في ستة سنين خمسة سنين ما حتى أكثر.
So without Polyter, this is you need 6 years to have a plant as big as this one. But now you just took 1.5 years
yes.
to have this.
بالضبط.
He also showed me these two olive trees to demonstrate Polyter's impact. Both trees are of the same age, less than 2 years old. Guess which one has been treated with Polyter? If you thought the one on the right, you are correct. But what is Polyter and how does it actually work? Who better to explain it than the man who invented it? Philip Owaki Di Giorno kindly agreed to talk to me. So I decided to hop on a plane and fly to France, specifically to Bordeaux, the wine capital of the world. Now I'm here to talk to the creator of Polyter. Hello. So tell us in simple terms, what Polyter is?
Polyter, en fait, c'est un granulé. On peut même le voir. On peut le prendre. Est-ce qu'on peut le prendre là?
Mm-hmm. This voilà. is it. Basically.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Voilà. Mm-hmm. Voilà. Polyter, c'est mm-hmm. un granulé de couleur vert mm-hmm. qui est à base de copolymères. De cellulose organique et de polyacrylate.
This mais is organic, right?
Maximum, mm. c'est mixte. Mm. Et à partir de ça, dans le process de fabrication, on y insère tout l'équilibre de NPK, de fertilisation, de la nutrition.
No big deal, super simple stuff. I mean, who doesn't know copolymer? And how do you pronounce this word? Polyacrylate. Seriously, what's important to know here is that all the ingredients are natural and degradable in the environment, according to him. In other words, they don't harm the plant nor the environment. This small granule, after coming in contact with water, in about 3 hours, it'll turn into this.
Au contact de l'eau, uh-huh. ça va absorber jusqu'à 300 fois son volume d'eau mm-hmm. sous forme solide.
That's voilà. it. Hold on, I think the best way to really grasp what Polyter does is to picture yourself going on a long trek through a barren desert. You would naturally pack extra water to drink in that arid landscape. Polyter works like that water container for plants, storing moisture in a solid form for future use. Back in Tunisia, Yamin, Polyter's country representative, demonstrated how farmers use the product in practice. He did the demo on a date farm. First, small holes were dug around a palm tree. Then a measured amount of Polyter is left in water for a few minutes to absorb and turn into these jelly-like shapes. Finally, the ballooned granules were buried in the holes. That's it, and Polyter will do its magic, providing water to the plant whenever it needs it. After olive, Tunisia is famous for its dates, particularly the Daglet Noor, or Date of Light variety. Called the queen of all dates, the Daglet Noor has a honey-like taste combined with a slight nutty flavor.
Thank you so much. So in Tunisia, because of drought, it's not just the olive trees that have been impacted, but also the palm trees. You know, palm trees usually don't need as much water, but apparently now they have been impacted and they are looking for solutions to keep growing palm trees.
The owner of this date farm explains that Polyter has also helped improve the quality of his dates.
thanks to the Polyter, we save the sweet part of the fruit day, of the fruit. That means the fruit is not dry. Mm. When we eat it, it's something like smooth, and we have all the taste of the fruit in your mouth.
That means juicy and
exactly like, yeah. Juicy and is
soft.
Soft. Mm. It's not hard to eat.
I'm already quite amazed by this technology, but I feel I need to know more. How scientific is Polyter? And is it proven to be effective for all plants? At the College of Agriculture in capital Tunis, I went to talk to an Oxford graduated professor who has been studying Polyter for years.
We were very interested to work on Polyter, and since 2 years we have been testing that in different crops, including wheat, vegetables, and fruit trees, and we observed an improvement of the efficacy of that kind of application in terms of reducing the drought stress in the plant, also the salinity stress, which is due to the irrigation of some plants with salty water.
He explained that his experiment involved two types of the same plant. One of them was treated with Polyter and given 50% less water than the other, which received its normal water amount without Polyter.
And the results showed that with Polyter, it's basically a game changer.
Yeah, it's more or less like the 100% irrigated. So by just giving the plants 50% of its needs and treating that with Polyter at the beginning of the crop cycle, you can have more or less the same results as 100% irrigated.
How did you come up with this idea?
Oh. Idée.
Let me pause the video and give you a shorter version of his long answer. Philip has always been interested in plants, but he was sad that he could not see ancient trees grow up in his lifetime. He basically wanted to plant a seed for a tree as tall as this one, for example, which usually takes hundreds of years to grow, but he wanted to do something to cut down that time a lot and make the plant grow to maturity in just a few years. Basically, he wanted to speed up nature, and that, he said, was where the idea for Polyter originated.
Que Polyter est vraiment une arme pour le bien, une arme pour pouvoir aider au changement climatique et aux problèmes de sécurité alimentaire.
If you like this story and would like to see more stories of life-changing and cool innovations, please consider subscribing to our channel, Rudaw Innovation. Thank you for watching.